How excited are you to be at the BAFTA Games, and how important is it to have the games industry honoured on this level?
Well, I'm completely and utterly thrilled, because I know that the BAFTAs are, you know, of all the awards in the world, I think they're the ones who really look at quality, and it's not so political, it's actually quality of work. So, I mean, I'm thrilled to be here. I can't be more grateful to be recognized by a body like BAFTA. And I think it's, I mean, of course it's important for any industry to kind of celebrate itself, and especially one that's so kind of on the cutting edge and as the gaming industry is. And it's nice for me as an actor to find that melding point between what we do and what the gaming community does. It's been a great experience for that.
Speaking of cutting edge, the next gen consoles are going to be coming out soon. Everyone's very excited. How will that affect your role as a voice actor?
Well, most of what I did was motion capture and performance capture. I'm not sure, because I'm not on the cutting edge of that part of the world. But everything so far seems to be making what we do more accessible. You know, so that what we do more visible to the, you know, to the motion capture cameras and to the performance capture cameras, as well as to the microphones and the animation that goes over top of us.
Is there any particular work that you're particularly proud of? Maybe something that you did, and then when you saw the finished thing, you were just like, wow.
In this game, Assassin's Creed. Oh gosh. Well, I have an episode of Supernatural coming out, and I think I'm very happy about that. It's episode 818. Freaks and Geeks, it's called. That's coming out in over the other side of the pond. Gosh, that's a difficult question. Put me on the spot. I've been an actor so long, and I've never been nominated for anything until now. That literally people say, what have you done? And I go, I don't know. I'll get my resume out and I'll look at it. But I suppose, I don't know how to answer that question at all. I did see some of the stuff I did as Haytham, and there's one or two scenes there in which I was very happy about, you know. So yes.
What scene was that?
Well, two of them in particular. The one on the rooftop with Connor, and I really liked the way that turned out, and as well as the scene with Washington, where Haytham gets to be really, you get to see a sort of dark, dark sort of cruel side, and as well as, you know, trying to prove his point at the same time. So the bad guy that I'm playing is not a bad guy. He's trying to make a point.
So for an actor, that's sort of quite an interesting dichotomy for
yes.
you.
Yes, for me. I mean, just to play someone who's supposed to be the bad guy of the piece, and yet I get to play him as a likable, charming, witty character for most of the game, until suddenly you find out the twist, which I probably shouldn't tell you because it's a spoiler. But
give us any hints?
Well, no. I mean, the game's out. I mean, it's all on YouTube anyway.
Assassin's Creed as well. Why does it continue to be so popular? Why do fans love it so much?
Well, I think it's this interesting mixture of storyline and placing it in historical. Each time it's a different historical place, and you combine the sort of sci-fi aspect of the time travel and the fight against evil and the two sides of, you know, the Assassins versus the Templars, and as well as the gameplay and the fighting and all that you get to play. And I think the wonderful thing about games is it engages people more as something they're involved in. And the combination of having that and as well being able to absorb a storyline and becoming involved in the characters, that's one of the top things for me about Assassin's Creed.
And do you know if you're going to be involved in the fourth game yet in any capacity?
If I knew, I could not comment.
And in the last 12 months, apart from the games you've worked on, are there any you've particularly enjoyed?
Mostly I do sort of episodic television. I just guest starred, as I mentioned, in a Supernatural episode, which should be out soon. A show which is going to be in the States called Motive, I have an episode in. There's an animated movie called The Clockwork Girl, in which I play a bumbling scientist, very different from the sort of charming Haytham Kenway character I got to play. But those are three things: Clockwork Girl and Supernatural and Motive.